Hello, my name is Cream and welcome back to Europa Universalis IV as Novgorod in our Frozen Assets campaign. So, what's happening? What's happening since last time? I totally forgot. So, people around us are unhappy with our aggressive expansion. There is some thing here. Some rebels. Sweden is being attacked by Denmark and Norway because Denmark wants to Sweden to be once again to be Denmark wants Sweden to be once again part of that alliance. Damn it! Totally forgot how it Kalmar Union. Yeah. Rebellion may happen. Bashkari separatists. Well, we need to fight them. Or harsh treatment them. We can afford them. Now we can reform government soon. March 1st, 1531. Administrative cadre. Great. Let's get to it. Now, we have manpower, we can make more states, Galich, well, those are not that great states. Truces will expire, in 2 years our truces will expire, great, we could attack them. Then Astrakhan, Uzbek, can we take Kazan? Nope, no Kazan. Uzbek, no, we don't have truces with Nogai, we have new Grand Knyaz. Moskvy. No, Novgorod getting claim on Kostroma, great. Longcliffe, our new ruler, whose bold fighter land leader shock plus one, great. He's 15 year old. Riga, what about your metropolis? Okay. Riazan, well, I don't care about you. Pskov is still Moscovite puppet. When are those in Moscow will end? It has ended! Moskvy, are you there with someone important? Teutonic Order, Galicia, Volhynia and Odiev. Well, good news is, Teutonic Order. Alive with Moskvy, can we attack them? Nope, because Riga doesn't have against them. Teutonic Order, Lithuania, you're allied with Ottomans. I hate this. No chance we can drag Lithuania into any war. Riazan, I still want to keep. I definitely don't want Moscow to be expanding. Oh, let's do some important thing. You return from Moscow. What the hell? How they are far too rich and powerful? They are not rich, they are not powerful. Give me land. Give me Moskva. Oh, you cannot give me Moskva? In that case, give me Kostroma. You are saying no? Oh, because we have truce. In that case, let's build spy network against them. Let's continue with that. So we are claiming everything. Let's claim this land. How much spy network do we need? 75. Well, we will see. So we have truces with all our neighbors except Lithuania, which I'm not gonna take because of Ottomans. And we don't have truces with Nogai. They are with Akvakululu, I don't care about them. Yeah, they are weak. We have alliance with Wallachia and Georgia, if I remember correctly. We can modify our government finally. So what do we want? Administrative clergy, administrative free policies plus one, I like that. Clergy will be more royal and more influential. Nobles of the rope. Leader cost minus 10%. Advisor cost minus 10%. This will save us monarch points. Like 5 every time we cannot get new leader. And we're gonna click that. Advisor cost, I'm okay with that. Like, we're gonna save some money, which I don't really care that much. Like, at the end, we are getting, well, we are losing money, but when you're gonna be stronger, you're gonna be getting out of money. So those two are, in my opinion, the most powerful. They both will save morale points. This will save iron points, this one will save military points. Your borders, you can be more loyal. Let's take nobles of the robe. And we are missing advisor, diplo guy. More of navy is diplomatic reputation. Let's get diplomatic reputation guy. It doesn't matter what tech can we do. Military tech 11, let's do it. This general is dead. Well, and we cannot click this button. We have to wait few more months. 29, 38. Yeah, we have to wait 2 more months. Uzbek. Let's claim this land. And we can claim Heliaba 2. We are doing spine for against Kazan. You have claims on them? Yeah. But we can get more claims. No problem with that. Moscow, we have tons of claims. And not Roosevelt and Van. What I thought we have truce. No, we don't have truce. I read it incorrectly. Cossacks. Novgorod, yeah, Lithuania, screw those guys. Border frictions with Lithuania. Casus belli, well, that sucks. What's happening here? France is at war with England, Austria and Hungary. Oh, okay. Bohemia is huge. Bohemia is at war with someone. With Austria, Teutonic Order, Brandenburg, Magdeburg, Saxony, Hungary, Salzburg, Augsburg and England. Bohemia, are you allied with? Nope, this is different, completely different war. Seems like France is attacking England and Austria is helping and Bohemia is attacking Austria and England is helping. Bashkirian separatists, Zlatoust and Bashkortostan. I thought I would make you into state. Or that was planned. I didn't make you into state. Well, let's do it. Let's obviously core both of you. And now we can increase autonomy. And let's harsh treatment those people. Or do I want to harsh treatment? They can fire, screw them. Permanent separatists? Yeah, they can fire too. We don't have freedom, let's recruit new general. 4-3-3-3, I like him. Arthur is Sweden expired. Now. Oh, Sweden! They are still independent, Denmark, but Denmark took out of states. Sweden, you don't have any alliances. Sweden. What's your army situation? Sweden, 12,000 men. Yeah, let's attack Sweden. We have claims. Well, yeah, we have claims. Oh, Finnmark is once again under Norwegian occupation. Or Norwegian control. You return from Uzbek. You return from Novgorod. We have long truce with them, so nothing's gonna happen. Let's convert some people. Let's do spine war against Sweden. Ships. Oh, you weren't defending anything. Okay, get to Abo. Now, we will gonna blockade Eastern Sea of Åland. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I'm gonna split army into several groups. Four of them. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, let's do this. Yeah, let's split this army into four groups. What's that? We can intervene. How? Oh, we are not fighting them. We are not helping England. Screw that. Oh yeah, those enemies have frozen. Let's kill them. Then you can return to Kazan. And then we can be ready to fight Permian separatists up here. Glazov, Ishkar, Heder to and Ustvim. So they may fire anywhere. Now, August armies, are you ready? Yeah, let's take Sweden. Declare war. Georgia and Valachia will join. Well, we don't need their help. Now you go to Dixavlax, Tavastland, Birkeland and Osterboten. And maybe I'm gonna split you in half and I want to see where are those, where is the Swedish army. And I want to see them if they are if they will be moving through Hälsingland. Oh, they are there. Okay, maybe get to Goof of Botnia so we can see this enemy army. As they will be moving into our territory. Okay guys, go to Rovaniemi. Two of you. Okay, you guys go to Kajanaland, you go to Enare. No, you go to Kajanaland, you go to Enare. No, you guys go to Rovaniemi. You go to Enare. You go to Osterboten. Kajanaland, how many troops can you support? Okay, I'm gonna split this army in half. How much money are we using? 2 ducats. We are in Age of Reformation, we've converted another nation, we certainly convert enough provinces. Let's kill those troops. You are done, go to Wasserbotten. You guys merge together or go to Jokmok. Okay, you go to Jokmok, you guys go to Lapland. We have 4 here, so we don't have to worry about we don't have to worry about Spermin Separatist controlling this province. What idea do we get? Another merchant, I like him. I like that idea. You know what, yeah, let's take that. Now, where are we gonna send that merchant to? Oh, we have 2 free merchants. Okay, maybe we could be cutting in White Sea. Novgorod, Astrakhan. Okay, let's send some guy there. Let's transfer power to Kazan. And, well, that's all. Kiev. No, let's send someone to Crimea. And this guy will transfer free power to Kiev. Great. You guys merge together. See Jokmok. Wasserbotten is in our hands. Great. Guys, go to Hälsingland. Oh! Where's our navy? Guys! Now, today we cannot blockade Western Sea of Poland. Jokmok is done. Yeah, go to Stockholm. Now, what siege guy do we currently have here? Level 3 guy. Yeah, okay, you stay here. Guys, go to Stockholm. Let's cut his army in Åland. So Stockholm is only Swedish fort. And it's fort level 1. Oh, Swedish army is returning. Okay, you guys stay here, let's wait until this army will come. Now, where is this Swedish army going? Well, we will see them from Bergslagen. So now, let's catch them in Stockholm. Hopefully Vibesec. Maybe, oh, damn it. Yeah, Vibesec. Great. Now, this is for level 1. That means we need 5 artillery. Everyone else can leave. And that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 provinces. Okay, I'm gonna split you into... few groups. And let's see the rest of Sweden. Oh, we are not blockading Stockholm, let's do it. Okay, I'm gonna split army into few groups. I'm gonna split you into two groups. And that's all. I could split, no, I cannot. Well, in theory I could, but let's not do it. Siege of Ostergotland will be finished soon. And Bergslagen, so you can go siege Dalsko again. Now, what's our aggressive expansion? Sweden, obviously no one cares. Well, Lithuania is a little bit unhappy, Muscovy. No one cares, Kazan is okay, so people are happy. Or, they don't mind that much. For now, we need to wait until our siege will be over. Guys, you can go to Abo. Siege of Stockholm is over, great. Let's wait until this battle will be over. Swedish separatists, okay. Could be interesting. So, what do we... Oh, owning this land, owning Stockholm would be nice. Bergslagen, Åland, Stockholm. Well, we'll see. If we're gonna sue for peace and we're gonna take Åland, Stockholm and Bergslagen, how much people will be unhappy? That's okay. Anything else we should take? Well, we definitely should take Finland, so those three provinces here too. So we can make Finland into a state. Sweden, you will give me war reparations and you will give me money. You will definitely give me less money. So now, what's our aggressive expansion? Sweden will be definitely unhappy, Lithuania unhappy, Moscovy and Kazan won't matter that much. Yeah, let's do it. So now we own Stockholm, nice. So let's score stuff. Stockholm definitely will be state. That I can tell you. Okay guys, stay in Stockholm. No, there is no fort. Grasen, well, in that case it's stupid to build fort there. Ships. Merge together and we don't need this galley. You can get to Helsing forts. You guys, you will protectorate in Novgorod. Denmark announced us as their rival. Well, screw Denmark. We are losing money. Can we declare one Uzbek? No, we still have truce for another year. In that case, no one cares. You return from Sweden, let's build spire against Uzbeks so we can attack them. And our colonists, or our first colonist, that would be nice to have colonists. It would be so nice. Right now we are focusing on triple points. Do we really want that? Straight tiering. Well, another merchant. R332. Treason against Novgorod. Let's get this so we can get army professionalism. Boyars are unhappy. Well, what can we do? Now, let's focus on Armin. Would be probably a little bit better. Now, let's play with estates. Let's definitely call that. So our... Oh, prestige is still going up. Nice. Now, let's grant them generalship. Can we... we can demand military support. Let's do it. But then they will be disloyal. A lot disloyal. Or really disloyal. Oh, Cossacks, can I give you land? Well, I could give you this one. Okay, Cossacks, that's yours. Cossacks, what can we do with you? Supply arms. We can also measure the power. Armed Cossacks, land force stamina modifier plus 15%. They will get influence. I'm okay with that. Permit self-governments. Local autonomy in Barshak's kind will go up. They will get influence up. Yeah, I definitely want that influence. Race Cossack host. We will get Eastern Hussar in Bashturkan. Cossack army. We can expand Cossack register. Let's do that. Oh, Archali is also step. We own only Archery from Volga. It's 18 development total, so I don't really care that much. And I'm gonna kick you out, Dmitry Tokmanov. We don't need you. But that Cossack! Army tradition, let's not do it. Let's raise that Cossack host. And we can kick this one out. Shock damage bonus plus 10%. Great. Now, let's play with other people too. Clergy, no. Burgers. Grant monopoly charters. Let's recruit minister. Let's do something else. Grant generalship, yep. Let's demand depot support. And ask for contribution. We can... They will be disloyal. But we need money. Clergy. Seek support of clergy. Recruit minister. And inquisitor. Oh, we still don't have enough influence. Well, that's unfortunate. We could give more land to clergy. Let's see. Clergy. What land I'm willing to give you? Definitely land with high autonomy. Oh, these Finnish provinces would have high autonomy. Obo has autonomy. And Helsforks has high autonomy. Okay. Abo goes to clergy. Helsforks. You. Damn it! What else? What else has high autonomy? And I'm willing to give it to clergy. No, well, nothing. In that case, Spirk mana and this one. Yeah, clergy is now really influential. Let's demand administrative support. Great! Exactly what I wanted. Now, 100 Spinefork. In that case, let's claim this. Oh, we've already claimed it. Great. We are getting claim on Ula. Awesome. Nice. Great. Question is... Well, I definitely want to attack Lithuania. Problem is that freaking... that unholy alliance with them and Ottomans. And let's be honest, Lithuania is really unhappy with our aggressive expansion. If anything, I want to expand. Now I want to expand to east. Into Uzbek territory. Uzbek, you are alive with someone important. Kazan and Tyarkant. So answer is no. I think one army here will be enough. Let's train more artillery. France announced us as their rival. How many people announced us as their rival? Moscow, Lithuania, Bohemia, Denmark and France. Well, France, why us? Somehow you probably cannot... No, England is strong. They should be able to make England into rival. Triumph of clergy, then influence will go up. Lose stability, I don't want to lose stability. I'm okay, stability goes very far, I'm okay with that. Clergy's influence will go up even more. So, Kazan, I think it's time for Perm to be released. Independence guaranteed by Moskva. You arrive with Astrakhan in Uzbek. Yarkand is... who knows? Oh, no, Astrakhan. I have no idea where Yarkand is. But they are not big. That means they are not... problem. I know there should be somewhere here. I know that, but... probably somewhere here. Well, I don't see them, so they are not problem. In that case, Kazan, what's your army situation? Like, I see those 3,000 troops. Is that all Kazan has? No. Oh yeah, that's all. Great. Uzbek, what's your army situation? 2,000. No problem. So, there's only 4 here in their capital. In that case, I'm gonna split this army in half. In that case, you guys go to Zatos, and I'm gonna split this army in half. Okay, I'm gonna split this army a little bit more. A little bit better. Okay, you guys get here. You will get leader, you won't get leader. You will get this leader, because we will be fighting this army immediately. Great, awesome. So soon our war against Uzbek will start. Question is when? November 1st, 1535. Yeah, in that case next month we will declare war on Uzbek. You are too from Muscovy. Let's build spy war against Kazan because we're gonna be at war with them. So, plan is to definitely cancel all alliances which Kazan has. Moscow defends them, which is nice. Still, I still don't understand why we cannot send warning. Like, oh, seriously, Moscow is not rich and powerful. No one believes that. Okay, army's ready. Oh, it's already December. Let's wait until January. January 1st is here. Let's declare war on Uzbek. Ryazan will join. I don't know. Oh, Kazan is not joining. Only Yarkand is. And I still don't know where Yarkand is, so... great! What do we want? Well, it doesn't matter what we're gonna take. In that case, this army needs to be led by a leader. You guys get to Zatost. And you know what? Let's finish this episode here. If you enjoyed this episode, please continue watching and have a nice rest of your day. Goodbye.